This is the RV Advisor Podcast with your host, Tom Alexander. Get all the latest information, trends, advice from experts, stories from the road, and more in the world of recreational vehicles. Now, here's Tom.
Welcome to the RV Advisor Podcast. I'm Tom Alexander. And joining me today is the founder and the owner of Lemon Protection. It's Jackie Winters. Hi, Jackie.
Good morning.
It's great to talk to you, and this is really, really interesting. I know that people are always concerned whenever they make a purchase that, I got a lemon. You know, what's going to happen here? So this, your company is kind of based on helping folks out. How long have you been in the business?
I've been in the business 36 years, and I've been doing lemon protection, 36 years. And I've been doing that. I started that out part-time because I was actually working for Cadillac Motor Car Division.
Oh, really? Interesting. So what were you doing there?
Well, I'm a heavy-duty line technician for Cadillac Motor Car. Mm-hmm. I'm certified diesel and other things, so I worked on diesels for Cadillac.
So you worked on diesels for Cadillac. And so you were no stranger to seeing maybe things coming off the production line that maybe weren't 100%, and so you were aware of these lemons that occasionally would sort of somehow sift through and get to the consumer, right?
Yes, I've had brand new cars with less than 1/10 of a mile on it, start the engine and blew up in the dealership. I've had to put new engines in them immediately.
Wow! So. Wow, that's unbelievable. So right back to square one, back to the drawing board, as they say. So with lemon protection, what is it about, your company that, you know, sort of the first line of defense? How does it help people?
Well, basically what happens is, I work with a lot of law firms in California and Arizona and Nevada. And if someone has a lemon, whether it's a car, truck, or a recreational vehicle, what they'll do is they'll probably contact one of the law firms. The law firm will contact me because I'm a certified mechanic in many areas and heavy duty as well. And they'll send me out to do an inspection on the vehicle. I'll take photographs. I'll go inside and out under it. And anything I see that's damaged, not connected, broken, loose, not fitted correctly, I'll photograph and document it. After I do that, I'll go back to my office. I'll do a complete report on it with research. I'll turn that over to the law firm.
Mm-hmm.
They'll contact the manufacturer and try to settle.
Right. And so do you find that you're probably always pretty busy, I would imagine, right? Yeah. Let's take a quick break, and we've got a lot more to chat about in just a moment. This is the RV Advisor Podcast, and we'll be right back.
Meet Terry and Carrie. They want an RV. Really, they want the freedom that comes with being able to pick up whenever they want and to move from one breathtaking view to another. The kind of freedom that takes them across the country and beyond, living their dream. But if they buy the wrong RV, it might actually pop their dream world. Maybe they pick one that's too heavy to tow for their vehicle. Or go with the wrong dealership who won't service their RV. There are questions to ask before they buy, and even more once they become an owner. Thankfully, there's the RV Advisor, the only non-biased platform for information for the RV and outdoor enthusiasts. Get the best tips, tricks, and discounts at all KOA nationwide campgrounds and other huge discounts that every RV enthusiast will love. Now, Terry and Carrie are living the life. Exactly how they want.
Visit theRVAdvisor.com or call 833-229-0911. And we're back on the RV Advisor Podcast. I'm speaking with Jackie Winters from Lemon Protection. He's based in Los Angeles, California. And so, you know, you talked about your experience having been on the line and working for Cadillac, among others, and as well as diesel engines and all that. You know, it's a lot of a lifetime of experience. And, you know, can you honestly say that in the last, I don't know, couple of years, anything that's come along that surprised you, or have you seen it all?
Well, I've seen a lot of things, but two things that was that did come up that was really surprising. One lady bought a RV out of Nevada, I believe it was, and was driving home. Got about 40 miles from the RV place, and the daggum side panel started peeling off. She got out and looked and said, "Oh, my God." And she called, and they actually told her, said, "Go to the next stop where there's a hardware store, box the screws and put it together, and we'll refund you for the screws." Isn't nothing about the labor. I was shocked.
Yeah.
I had a second one where a gentleman bought a new mobile home. They're out in the park doing their stuff, and all of a sudden he goes to the restroom like we all do, and he said he sets down and gets finished and flushes the toilet while he's still sitting, and all of a sudden it went back up at him.
Ah, yes.
Yes.
Yeah, it's not not too pleasant, is it?
Oh, God. That guy was furious, and he said it made a big mess, obviously, and he flushed the toilet, and I caught it on camera. I couldn't believe it. I've never seen that.
Wow. Wow. Yeah. That's new stuff, I guess you could say. Yeah, we could use a different word, but we won't. But that's, wow, that's really, really something to contend with, obviously. So you got that resolved for him?
Yes, sir. We did. Both those cases actually settled. It's very rare for one of these big mobile homes to go to court because the attorneys, one attorney I work with here in Los Angeles, I've been with him 17 years.
Yeah.
I'll tell you, this guy is absolutely one of the best I've ever met, and I work with 25 law firms.
Wow.
But this guy's up. He does RVs. He's on top of it, and he's really good. But they rarely go to trial on these here.
Yeah. Well, I mean, look, listen, I guess the RV manufacturers and dealerships, just they want to avoid bad publicity, so they want to settle out of court, I guess, right?
Well, a lot of them do, and a lot of times the people will actually, they'll actually give you some money back sometime. You can negotiate, you know, they'll negotiate that sometime, or they'll buy the stuff back or whatever. You, that's between you and the attorney, though.
Yeah, and so when you're working with the attorneys, you know, how much do you have to sort of supply them? I mean, because I'm assuming that not all attorneys are also RV experts, so you're the expert, you come in, you understand how everything's, you know, what the issue is. How much do they depend on you for all that information?
Well, quite a bit, because if I have to go on the witness stand, I have to talk about every part of that mobile home or car or truck, whatever it is.
Yeah.
Every part I find that's bad, damaged, loose, I explain what it is, where it is, what it's going to take to fix it.
You know, I was talking to some folks in on a video cast that we do, and people from our office and actually the owner and founder, Gigi Stettler, as well as our operations manager. And, you know, I asked them, because I'm sort of like trying to connect. I'm a little bit of a novice certainly when it comes to mechanics I am, but in terms of, you know, trying to be the liaison really between understanding the industry and then also trying to be the, you know, from the consumer's perspective. And I asked them, you know, how much does a regular auto mechanic know about you know, RVs and fixing RVs? And the answer they had was, well, being a mechanic is a mechanic to some degree. A lot of this, there's a lot, you know, engines and all that are kind of universal in most cases. But, you know, the technology aboard the RVs is a whole other animal. And so you really have to, you know, you came from the auto world and now, you know, you're with RVs. So you really kind of have to have a working knowledge of all the latest technology coming out as well, I assume, right?
Yes, I have to take a test every 5 years from ASE Automotive. It's Automotive Service Excellence, to prove to them so I can wear their badge, just as they've certified me as knowing what I know.
Yeah.
Now, in the mechanics part, most mechanics, if you can work on a car engine, transmission, brakes, or steering, you can work on a mobile home. It's just bigger parts.
Right.
The complication comes in with these new mobile homes is with the electronics, and that's why we have these computers we carry with us. We put it into the computer, it runs the scan, it tells us the codes. Come back to my office, I search all the codes, find out what it is, and I put all that in my report. I photograph and document it so I can say, look, I got a code PO04. That means number 4 cylinder, and the engine's not firing right.
Mm-hmm.
I'll document it, I'll prove it. If I can make a video here and it's misfiring, I'll make a video. And then that's part of my report.
Yeah. So when you were working for, were you in Detroit in you know, your formative time, early days of your auto experience, or where were you based?
I was in New Orleans, Louisiana, and mm-hmm. I went down there. I worked on big tractor-trailer trucks as an apprentice for a year.
Mm-hmm.
Then I went to work for a Shell Oil Company distributor, and they certified me in Detroit diesels so I could work on diesel. Mm. They wanted to make sure I was certified and knew what I was doing.
Yeah.
I worked there for a year or so, and I came to California. I went to work for Chrysler on mobile homes. This is my first mobile home job, period. I worked at Dependable Dodge in Canoga Park.
Yeah.
And I did heavy-duty work. I did all the, you know, the engine, transmission, steering, whatever it was.
Right.
And that's where I got into mobile homes more. And since then, I've actually got a close friend with a mobile home. I've maintained it for the last 5 years for him.
Yeah.
And, so I've got a lot of experience in mobile home. My stepfather, he's on several, and I help him with those, take care of those.
Where's home originally?
Well, I was born in Arkansas. I grew up in the South. I'm a Southern.
Yeah. I detect just a little trace of that. It doesn't sound like an L.A. accent to me, if there's such a thing.
Yeah, it's funny. When I came to L.A., a lot of people made fun of me, and they called me the, you know, Jethro Bodine.
And, what the world is it?
And I knew it was my voice, so I had to try to get rid of that strong accent.
Yeah.
So,
well, you know what? There's a charm and you know, earthiness about it that I find quite appealing, actually. And you're in the middle of Tinseltown, so I guess I have to ask: how often do you have to service either, you know, help studios out or celebrities or anything with you know, some of the high end mobile homes or RVs or, you know, any of that stuff? Does that ever come up?
Yeah, I work for Hollywood National Studio.
Ah.
He sold the studio a few years back, but he had a mobile home that he used to transfer movie stars around, and I met quite a few movie stars and
uh-huh.
actually worked on a few other cars, but I never really got into, you know, their stuff. I just, you know, it's polite conversation. I never really said, well, give me your autograph. I never asked for that.
Yeah. Well, listen, you're doing them the favor, you know what I mean? I mean, you're getting them hooked up in a big way, and so they should be asking for your autograph, I think. But that's great. So, I mean, so you see that's obviously, you know, there's a need in that industry for that. I mean, because almost all the time, particularly if movies or TV shows are on location, there's lots of RVs on the lots for people to stay. You know,
I've been called quite a few times on some of the mobile homes they use for carrying the stars around. I've been called quite a few times from different studios to go out and look at them and see what's going on with them. I've done that a lot, but the one particular one was Hollywood National. I mostly worked on his, and I worked on his big trucks and tractor trailers.
Yeah.
And people, he would tell other people, say, look, my mechanic can take care of that, call him up. That's how I got into the movie industry.
Right.
I still work for some people now part-time.
Is Hollywood National in Burbank?
It's in Hollywood, California, on Seward Street.
Oh, okay.
He's the actual guy that did Elvis Presley via Hawaii.
Oh, no kidding. Wow, okay. Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's got some history there, that's for sure. But, yeah, I got to do a little work out there myself a few years back, and we're basically, you know, we're based out of Burbank, but... interesting town, that's for sure. But so once again, if you could tell the folks if they want to learn more about Lemon Protection, Jackie, let folks know where they can go.
Well, they can go to my website, lemonprotection.com.
Mm-hmm.
And if you want, you can go to the blog area and you can read some of the stories I've written about some of the cases I've done. And it's just that simple. If you want me to do a report for you, or if you want me to inspect your car, or your motorhome or whatever you got, I can do that for you. If you need an attorney, in my section of my website, there is several attorneys I trust and use mm-hmm. them with for years and years. The only reason I refer them because I've worked with them, I know they're honest. Because one thing I don't do is refer anybody that I think is going to cause you a problem. I don't do that.
Well, that's good to know. And, yeah, absolutely. It's you want someone you can trust. That's critical. And so there you go. It's once again, Lemon Protection, lemonprotection.com. Jackie Winters is the founder and the owner, and he's been our guest today right here on the RV Advisor Podcast. Jackie, thank you so much.
All right, sir. Thank you, and you have a good day, and God bless you.
Likewise. This is the RV Advisor Podcast. I'm Tom Alexander. Thanks for listening. Thanks for watching. So long, everybody.